They're the original girl group that we grew up listening to in the 80s. And over 25 years on, Bananarama have still got it. We caught up with the two remaining members, Sarah and Karen, at the Milk Festival over the weekend. Before Girls Aloud, before the Sugar Babes, and long before the Spice Girls, there was the ultimate girl band with attitude, Bananarama. And judging from their crowd-pleasing performance at Milk over the weekend, childhood friends Sarah and Karen haven't lost the edge that made them the biggest-selling all-female group ever. And looking back, the girls reckon the years have been pretty good to them.
Well, we started as not as a joke, but you kind of think when you're 18, okay, we've had a couple of hits, we're on top of the pops, and that was like really weird. And then you can't actually believe it. We've been going for so long. It's like almost 28 years and still going strong.
They certainly are. We all know that Bananarama famously took part in the original Live Aid back in 1985. And today, the ladies are still delighted to have been part of music history.
It was so amazing. I mean, we knew Bob Geldof and we shared an office. And he said, girls, come on, get down. And we're like, what's going on? We got out of it. We'd been out the night before. I think we had a hangover.
Yeah, you can tell with me.
Yeah, and we got out and there's like Sting and Bono and Paulella, and we just thought, what's going on? And it was so massive, and really proud to have been part of that.
And as Karen and Sarah are pretty much girl band royalty at this stage, what do they make of girl groups hogging the airwaves today?
I think it's very different. Most of the girl bands around now have come through, if you're talking Girls Aloud, they've come from a completely different background, and they don't necessarily write the songs, and it's not, we came through punk really, so we were very do-it-yourself,
and we wrote all our own stuff, yeah. Managed ourselves, so and kind of styled ourselves, so
we never thought
kind
of ourselves as a girl band.
Okay, so the anti-girl band it is then. And with all their knowledge of the industry, we think these two straight talkers would slot in perfectly on the X Factor judging panel. But what's their verdict?
Well, we have the experience, so certainly. A lot of advice, but
I think you can tell instantly if somebody's got the X Factor. I mean,
I think we'd be slightly brutal. Too brutal, maybe.
Yeah. Yeah, we have a feeling the girls could give Simon a run for his money anyway. But besides being musical heavy hitters, Bananarama were undoubtedly serious trendsetters back in the day. And now it seems they finally passed on the fashion torch.
It's really weird because I've got an 18-year-old daughter and
I hoard
my clothes and all the World's End stuff, Vivian Westwood stuff, and she wears it now. She looks fantastic in it.
And you don't?
No, I don't now. I'm afraid it doesn't fit me. It's a bit tight. We've best to leave Topshop out of it now. You can't really fit into it.
That's the beauty of Sarah having an 18-year-old is you go to Topshop and you think, I can't do it.
Leave it back away.
I sometimes try a dress on, and Sarah said, "Yeah, Alice put that one on, and she looked really good in it, but you don't." So that's how we work.
Well, whatever you're doing, we think you're both looking fab, ladies. Keep up the good work.